Claire, I don't understand two words in a sentence when you grab.
For your information, I'm doing a term paper on Sherlock Holmes.
I sure feel sorry for the professor's reading.
The woman's an imbecile, Holmes. Best to ignore the creature. Go right ahead. I consider it a compliment to be ignored by you two. You're a scandal to the whole university. Last year, you were Edgar Allan Poe. I certainly got tired of those nevermores. Your mother must have been frightened by a lending library.
Holmes, are you guys happy with this?
I'm inclined to think so. That's what Sherlock would have said.
The Dean of Women, right, has threatened to kick me out unless my grades improve.
For the third time this semester, I find all discussion of creepy crawling things repulsive.
You'll care plenty if your mean old Pappy finds out you've been expelled for 4 grades.
Lost in the ashes of time.
Oh, situation for all it is. I'm sure it's what Sherlock would say.
I wish this two were part poison.
Not as
I hear a little time ago in the corridor outside my room.
She means room. Go on.
I have been leaving.
No. Fifi, you mean sleeping.
Oui, sleeping.
Merci, Monsieur Holmes.
When I hear someone tell someone they wish they be dead.
Who?
Alas, I do not know.
Too bad. Sounded interesting. Don't hear a good conversation like that too often. Well, Watson, let's get on with it. Some more Sherlock's observations.
Observations? How do you think about old Mossy observation at a time like this?
The water is too hot. I do not want to be in the center of town. The dining room proudly presents your dinner.
Are you ready, Watson?
Quite ready, Holmes.
Splendid.
There are 75 perfumes, which it is very necessary that a criminal investigator should be able to distinguish from each other. That's from...
Don't tell me. It's from the Hound of the Baskervilles.
Gad, Holmes, you're amazing.
Elementary, my dear Watson. That's what you're reading from.
Ugh. Guys!
It's Mrs. Hudson.
Stay where you are. Don't anyone move.
What is it, Holmes?
Bitter almonds. I distinctly smell bitter almonds. Mrs. Hudson is dead.
No.
Let me out of here!
Stand right where you are, Melanie. No one leaves this room. Watson, the door.
At once, Holmes. Have you lost what little precious sense you possess? Mrs. Hudson has probably got a horror seizure.
Call the gendarme!
Call the doctor!
Call my agent!
The key, Holmes!
I'm going to throw up. May I be excused?
S'il vous plaît. I don't understand. What has happened?
Happened? Murder. Just happened to be cold and delivered.
What murder?
Mrs. Hudson, of course. Bless you.
Thank you. I don't want to be in here with a dead body.
I'm afraid you'll have to. You seem to have to point my finger at the murderer.
Murderer!
In this case, the proper word would be murderess.
It's your overactive imagination playing red.
That corpse is not my imagination, nor the strong odor of belladonna in the tea.
Bella who?
Belladonna, from the Italian. Ordinarily, it means beautiful lady. But lethodosis means death. Related to deadly nightshade plant.
Holmes' knowledge of botany is astonishing.
He fell off on belladonna.
But belladonna doesn't smell of bitter almonds, you fool. That's cyanide.
Hmm. And the murderess is even more clever than I suspected.
Oh. I'm going to faint.
I'm weak for hell.
I should inform you that I'm an expert at judo. I trust I shan't be forced to prove my prowess. Watson, you better see the thief.
At once, Holmes.
Shouldn't we cover Mrs. Hudson or something? It's a beast to have her sit about which let her breathe.
Good thing, Kimani. Watson, be a good chap and throw something over the old lady. That person might do.
Not a roof!
I have the very thing. I have a question.
What is it, Sipples?
Are we going to get in trouble because of what you did to the telephone?
No!
Trouble.
Trouble.
I'm the only one here who knows what trouble is. My whole life has been nothing but trouble.
Hey, Shirley.
What do you think we should wear about this thing again?
Great Scott, woman. This is no time to be worrying about clothes.
Style is very important. Appearances count.
We will be on TV, don't you think?
I don't know what all my boyfriends are going to say about all this. They're Melanie Shook involved in a murder scandal.
You'll all be freed from blemish once a true criminal is apprehended. Watson, have you my magnifying glass?
I have it, Holmes.
And just what, may I ask, are y'all going to do with that? Study footprints.
Footprints?
There is no branch of the neglected.
That's from the case of the five orange pips, for sure.
You're mistaken. It's from a lesson in work entitled Garbage.
God, Holmes, you're amazing.
But Monsieur Holmes, there are no footprints on the teacher.
You have a point there.
The only point around here is the shape of your cranium.
Besides, there are more footprints around here than a theater lobby.
True. Mrs. Hudson wasn't much of a vacuum cleaner. Plainly, the potion was administered via tea. East Indian tea, judging by the color. Devilish stuff.
Tea is very commonplace.
It's a pen upon it. There is nothing so unnatural as commonplace. What we must decide is who administered the nefarious substance.
What is nefarious?
She's an ancient Egyptian queen, I think.
Nonsense, Nipples. That was never TT.
Oh, yes. Does anyone have a cough drop? There's a scratch in the back of my throat.
It's Mrs. Hudson that we're interested in. Or rather, the neck. We know that Mrs. Hudson was sipping the tea when she revealed the motive for her murder.
The damaging letters.
Elementary. Are you getting all this down, Watson?
Most of it. I intend to add this case to my memoirs.
Sensible. What we must discover is who put the belladonna in Mrs. Hudson's teapot.
Very amusing, Holmes. You make it sound like who put the overalls in this murderous cabin.
I don't understand the matter. You wouldn't.
Now, laughter does seem somewhat out of place in Mrs. Hudson turning stiff over there at her desk.
In a macabre sense, we might say Mrs. Hudson died of a writer's cramp.
I don't think anyone put poison in the tea. Let's not forget, Mrs. Hudson left the room for something.
Good Lord, Holmes! It was the saccharin!
Elementary, my dear Watson. Elementary.
There was nothing wrong with my saccharin. 1 gram equals 2 teaspoons. That's all.
But you knew that if Mrs. Hudson wrote home that your love of hypochondria was flourishing here, your parents have put an end to it all.
No! Besides, there's nothing wrong with me. I'm just unhealthy. And why did it have to be a saccharin? Why couldn't it be the tea? Maybe the poison didn't act right away. And who served the tea?
Good Lord, Holmes! It was Melanie!
Elementary. You two had every reason to see that Mrs. Hudson never reached her ballpoint.
Oh! And if we're all happy now that her time is being spent through them instead of her bigs, he'd fetch her back to the Elk Plantation, where you can say,
"Gone with the wind."
I didn't do it! Not me! I mean, nah-uh!
Monsieur Holmes, the voice. I have just recalled the identity of its target.
This could be important.
You recall the conversation I mentioned as taking place outside my room where I was sleeping.
What you mean to say is while you were sleeping with your broom. I mean, while you were sleeping in your tomb. Room.
It was a very, how you say, dramatic voice, like an actress would regress.
You mean possessed, Phoebe. Dramatic voice like an actress would possess. An actress.
Good Lord, Holmes! It was Theta!
Elementary.
Nonsense. I'm like totally innocent of this crime. You're forgetting an important detail.
I never forget. The elephant and I have much in common.
Big ears.
One letter was already written and ready to be delivered. Whoever that letter is written about is so the murderer.
Good Lord, Holmes! It was me!
I hardly think so. As Holmes once said, I never get your limits, Watson. There are unexplored possibilities about you. However, you'll never get me to believe you'd stoop to something as foul as doing it, Mrs. Hudson.
Thank you, Holmes. You're a brick.
That leaves us back with you, Theta. Mrs. Hudson's denunciation, coupled with our report from the Dean of Women, probably would have been your end here at the university.
Go on.
You did meddle at the desk. When you toyed with the teapot, I noticed that the thumb of your left hand was dipped in. And it was you who said, "Oh, how I wish this tea were poison."
Damn! I can't believe it.
Neither can I. In fact,
She's something of a ham, too.
That's key personalities, Alice. You confess to stealing the president's toupee if it would get your name in the yearbook.
But Holmes, where is all this getting us?
Patience, Watson. I'm about to make a deduction.
Quiet, everyone. Holmes is deducing.
But why? Monsieur Holmes is not fat, my God.
Fifi, please!
Poor Mrs. Hudson. She was a stray chicken in a world of boxes. Gobbled up before time.
If you don't let me out of here, I'll scream until Christmas.
In that case, I'll be forced to give you a Juno chop to the chin.
I advise against any rash action. Holmes here is a demon when aroused.
Everything is too pat, too obvious. Nothing makes sense. Only an imbecile brew poison tea and let everyone see her servant.
Unless the imbecile believed that being obvious, she could avert any suspicion.
But that would take a clever imbecile. Melanie's an imbecile, but she's not clever.
I beg your pardon!
On the other hand, Sniffle's poignantly drawing attention to the saccharin presents something of a puzzle.
Why?
Because I picked up that saccharin bottle myself shortly after dinner. Believing its true owner misplaced it. I intend to post a bottle of saccharin found on the bulletin board at the earliest opportunity.
Holmes, are you suggesting Mrs. Hudson drank unsweetened tea?
Or she may have drunk her brew of fine sugar. In any case, I'd say my saccharin theory is double times.
I'm ready.
I happen to know that you're in rehearsal for a mystery thriller at the University Playhouse.
But I would be so good for the jury.
Jury? What? Jury?
I can help your reputation.
Nonsense, Tita. Bribery has no chance of me. The solution to the perfect crime is all the reputation I need. No, it wasn't the tea. And it wasn't the saccharin. Or the machinations of an emotional woman. Watson, do you recall the murder weapon in the sign of war?
Of course I do, Holmes. It was used by the monstrous little barbarian named Tonga. Good Lord, Holmes, it was a blow dart murderer.
Elementary, my dear Watson. We're all diverted. The killer blew a dart into Mrs. Hudson's hairdo, and could we all assume it was either the tea, the saccharin, or Theta Safam. I've solved the case.
Well, tell us!
When a woman thinks our house is on fire, as Sherlock once remarked in A Scandal in Bohemia, her instinct is to at once rush to the thing she values most. A married woman grabs at a baby, and an unmarried one reaches for her jewel box.
There's no babies or jewel boxes in here.
When Theta screamed, only Fifi here reached for anything. Her handbag.
No.
Aha! The blow darts.
No, that is a plastic straw. I don't like paper straws when I sip Coca-Cola.
Aha! The poisonous venom. Undoubtedly from the reaches of the upper Amazon. Bitter almonds.
No, edu cologne.
I don't see the darts. Possibly a file down hairpin or sewing needle.
No. God, I'm going to faint.
The irons, Watson.
Captain Holmes.
You're a clever creature, Mademoiselle Fifi. I haven't met up with such a mind since I did with the Phoenix Recover Professor Moriarty.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I killed Mrs. Hudson because she was blackmailing me for my past. Better for me that she was dead.
All very well done, Theta, but the case is solved.
Fifi turned out to be a foreign menace.
What is menace?
Unlock the door, Watson.
At once, Holmes.
Come along, Fifi. I'm taking you to the yard. Inspector Lestrade will be interested in meeting such a catch.
What is catch?
Get this thing off me.
Oh my God.
What is going on here?
Sure, it's too hot.
She is alive! Oh my God, I should throw myself in a river right now.
I'm waiting.
Cheryl, Jared told us you were dead.
Dead? First you thought it was that awful Nastana in your teapot.
Well then of course we thought it was that
sacrament.
Or
feed a thumb.
Right here.
Yes.
Anyway, Fifi's there.
Fifi? Fifi did what?
I don't know.
With her dart and she was out just like Tonga.
Tonga? Who's Tonga?
One moment, you two. You looked dead?
Of course, for your concern, Mrs. Hudson. It's not easy to tell.
For your information, Holmes, I took a doctor prescription to help me sleep at night. I've trouble with insomnia, which is understandable living under the same roof as you girls. The medication kicked in a bit too fast. Will you girls excuse me? I need to talk to Holmes and Watson.
We'll go.
Melanie, can you go park my car up front?
Of course. Who is Inspector Littlewick? Thank you.
Genius have a remarkable power of stimulating it.
That's from the Hound of the Baskervilles. That great ship.
I am not concerned about the writings of Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. What I'm concerned about is you girls. Fifi in handcuffs, Sniffles going on about someone named Tonga. Where will it end? If you do not stop this, I'm going to call your father immediately.
You mean you're gonna use the telephone?
Of course the telephone. How else would I reach him? Need a tom-tom? He lives about 1,000 miles away.
Not far enough. I have come to an entirely erroneous conclusion, which shows, my dear Watson, how dangerous it always is to reason from insufficient data.
Oh, that's just what I'm talking about. If you do not stop this nonsense with Sherlock Holmes immediately, I will not only call your father, but I will also take it up with the Dean of Women. That could mean expulsion.
But Mrs. Hudson,
I'm waiting.
Well,
Dottie?
I promise.
Shirley?
I promise. Forgive me, Sherlock.
Great. Now that that's settled, we can now return back to Sandy by returning this covering back to where it belongs. It does not belong on my head.
Mrs. Hudson! Mrs. Hudson!
What is it, Melanie?
Your car is not there!
What do you mean? It has to be there. Perhaps I forgot where I parked it. I've done it on occasion.
No, I saw two men drive up the street with it. Mrs. Hudson, your victim car leads out to Claire.
Quick, Melanie, go get the police on the corners. I've got to call police headquarters.
No need to call the Scotland Yard, Mrs. Hudson. Watson and I will handle this.
No, wait.
We won't hold you to your promise, Mrs. Hudson.
My promise?
Come along, Watson. No time to dilly-dally. The game's afoot.
Shall I take notes, Tom?
No. Shirley? Dottie? Hello? Hello? The game's afoot, all right, but the phone is dead.